I go, God, you've been in here twice already. He goes, Miss Dioli, the Wake Forest kids consider Dioli as one of the four major food groups. when we moved here in 99, Roger actually owned the catering company that catered the box, the luxury suites to Candlestick Park and 49ers and the Giants. Roger and I were both in the restaurant business, got out of it, we met, got back into it, opened a restaurant in the Bay Area, fighting that if we wanted to have more children, we'd have to move out of the Bay Area, it's just too expensive. So we sold both of our restaurants and picked up and moved. Moved to Winston-Salem. But quite honestly, I think the best part is Wake Forest. Honestly, the students are a huge part of our business. They're all usually in a really good mood when they come in, and they just want to eat instead of feeding our kids. So we don't know you by your name. We know you by fresh mozzarella at Chicken Crest Extra.
Catering to the Wake Forest students, and this, I'm not saying this in a negative way, wasn't a business plan. The business plan was opening more of an Italian market like we were used to in the Bay Area. Unfortunately, we may have overestimated Winston-Salem, the general population's interest in that. In turn, what happened unexpectedly was that we caught on that first year with the Wake kids, going back to 2007 when we opened. And it was amazing because we had kids coming in here, a lot of them from the Northeast that really knew what we were trying to do and got it right away.
There's six or seven sandwiches on the menu that were inspired by Wake Forest students. Well, the egg paninis. Some guys came in our first year and they were like, you know, Ms. Dioli, it's great that you have cinnamon rolls and donuts and everything, but we don't want something sweet in the morning. So we have the Italian sausages already in-house, of course, with all the bacon, very happy eggs. So thus came the egg sandwich. And then the kid walked in one day and said, why don't you have a chicken cutlet sandwich? Well, there was the grilled chicken breast. And then someone else came in and said, what about, and I'll be honest, most of them were guys. And, you know, where's the chicken parmesan? So we started making chicken parmesan. The fresh mozzarella was one of the girls' ideas. Adding chicken to it was one of the guys' ideas. The southern bird was just the way the students started putting sandwiches together. So then we would just kind of run with that as a sandwich. So it takes a lot of time and a lot. I mean, like all the cookie recipes. When I turned 30, my auntie Sarah and I are very, very close. She's my dad's sister. And when I was young, when I was little, I used to go to her house and bake with her. And when I turned 30, she called me and she said, okay, sweetie, what do you want for your birthday? I said, I want all of the family recipes, because they're all right here. She has nothing written down. So she got on her little typewriter, and she typed them all out for me, put them into sleeves, put them in a binder, and FedExed them to me for my birthday. So those are all Auntie Sarah's cookie recipes that are all there. Those are all authentic Morello family. That's my name, Morello family recipes. And these are all family photographs of them too. Roger's parents, my parents. Okay, my favorite thing that you guys order is the hero, because that's the fastest sandwich. Okay, see, here they all come. Because I told you, it was like, oh. It's because it's the fastest sandwich to make. But the best sandwich to make is the grilled chicken breast, because that one, is, when it's done, is but the Italian hero on a busy day, we timed it. We can knock out sandwiches in about 20 seconds if we, get set. We counted one day. There are days where it's a lot of sandwiches.
This thing's authentic.
Yeah.
That's kind of the base. That's where we start. When we do things Italian, we try to make it the way we grew up with it, the way we know it should be. You know, coming from San Francisco, deli shops, that kind of thing.
I'll tell you a really great story. It's very sad, but it makes us feel really good about what we do here. I might get a little misty. So in September, you had a student pass away. He was killed in a car accident, shot. Right. So his mother called me and said, she told me who she was, and she said that she wanted to cater food for all of the guys in his fraternity house for Super Bowl Sunday. So she gave me a list of what she wanted to do and got me in contact with the president of the fraternity house. And I picked up my daughters, and we delivered to the fraternity house and six different other homes where guys in the fraternity house live. And we were so happy to do it, but she told me, she said nothing would make her son feel better than knowing that all of his friends were eating Dioli's on Super Bowl. Yeah. So, you know, when something like that happens, all the hard work is so worthwhile because, you know, we made somebody who's going through a horrible time, just gave her a little bit of something to be happy about if she can take care of all of these friends and her sons. Mm-hmm. So, you know, the food business is a hard business to be in. But then you walk in here, and honestly, 99.9% of the time, every white kid that walks in here is in a good mood. They're very polite, you know. Like I said, I don't know them by name, but I know them by sandwich. So, you know, and then when they come back to see you at homecoming, it makes, you know, it's pretty cool. It is.